You're watching USA, America's favorite cable network.
Last week, here are the superstars of wrestling. We saw one of the most despicable double-teaming acts that I have ever eyewitnessed. Matching their abilities and feats of strength are none other than Canadian strongman Dino Bravo and the reigning Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior. Let's go to the footage.
Down on the mat.
He may be the ultimate
champion. Again, I repeat,
when this is
the
over,
weight of this man is 460 pounds. 460 pounds. John, go right ahead. Go right ahead. All right, he is up there. Okay, Ultimate Warrior. What? What's this?
He just gave it.
Wait a minute!
Whoa!
Bravo!
What?
Falling through an elbow!
See, I told you, McMahon, that he couldn't push up that big John character.
He didn't have a chance!
Yes, he did! He set his weight on him and the Warrior collapsed!
Look at this! Bravo! And this belt of a man down across the chest!
Hey, this guy learned how to wrestle pretty quick!
Yeah, no kidding! I smell a rat!
You smell a rat?
Feats of strength might be pushing it a bit. Right now, let's hear from Mr. Bravo and his accomplice, if you will. A man known only as the Canadian Earthquake.
It's such a great moment for us. That's right. I've proven to the whole world that I am the world's strongest man. I've did multiple push-ups with this big 460-pound man sitting on my back. Ultimate Warrior, you couldn't do it.
Watch me waste the Macho Man with Acclaim's WrestleMania for the Nintendo Entertainment System. A leg drop, an elbow smash, a body slam!
WWF WrestleMania from Acclaim.
Ooh, yeah, I want a rematch.
Well, as well.
Well, I think Bravo totally proved he's the stronger man right there, McMahon.
Yeah, with the Canadian Earthquake on his side, perhaps.
At his side, you mean on his back. Gorgeous tights.
Well, you go, all right. Nonetheless, Roddy Piper counting the days of this Thursday when his team, Roddy's Rowdies, will meet the team captained by the man in the ring, Rick Rude, Rude's Brood. And right now, ravishing Rick Rude, pretty much in control of things. Got an occasion a little bit earlier to speak with Bobby the Brain Heenan, who apparently is a little upset over the cover of this week's magazine.
There's a lot of things in this world that make me sick, but this guy here tops the list. That's right, Rowdy Roddy Piper on the cover of the World Wrestling Federation magazine. And inside he says what he's going to do to ravishing Rick Rude. Oh no, Piper, it's not going to happen like that. This Thursday night is Survivor Series. You, your team, and the magazine are finished.
Confident words of the Brain.
And you know what else? Bobby never lies. I've known this man for a long time, and his integrity is impeccable, McMahon.
Yeah, I bet. Oh, no.
Well, that could well be Piper right there. We may be getting an example.
Oh, my goodness. There, the Rude Awakening. One for him, Abbott, and the three count. And if the Rude Awakening is placed on Rowdy Roddy, or for that matter, Super subject herself to this.
You notice it's always the best looking one in the entire arena.
Oh!
That gets the ring.
Aren't you the luckiest female walking the earth? And aren't you happy to be in the same ring with Ravishing Rick Rude? Help yourself, Tuts.
He didn't let her answer the question. This Thursday.
You know, I think that's the most devastating rude awakening right there.
I think so, huh? Rowdy Roddy will have something to say about that.
Spotted. And the model was already dancing dirty, while the rest of us were merely staying alive. It's fall, and there's a chill in the air, and the model doesn't care. As always, he is prepared with their staggering array of hand-imported knitted sweaters. He is a Nano Baker.
I am the model. Yes, as you just see, a masterpiece of motion, a walking work of art. And you know what? Looks could kill. I'd be called Jack the Ripper. So from now on, observe at your own risk.
I can't believe the model. Woody Collins. Oh, boy. This guy didn't show up this Thursday night. If he does, I hope he's the turkey.
You brothers and sisters.
I just hope he never ends up in Rochester,
at
Minnesota.
Time,
why would anyone end up in Rochester, Minnesota?
Inside joke, McMahon.
$1 million team.
Figures.
That is captained by my benefactor, Brother Million Dollar Man.
Wait a minute. He's not scheduled to have the $1 million team this week.
By the powers of pain, the warlord and the barbarian, along with the human wrecking machine, suit. But instead, I will introduce to you the team that will not survive this Thursday night.
Extraordinary team, Jesse. And they are psyched. Taking, however, nothing away from the $1 million team at all.
That's an extraordinary team, too.
Yes,
it's
it
gonna
is.
It's going to be an extraordinary matchup, to say the least.
Brother Love, Hulk Hogan and Hulkamania would survive against anything. But with all these guys on my team, I'm not worried about it one bit. Just listen to yourself talk, Brother Love. We already know that you're on the side of the team that is going to lose and not survive the multi-million dollar man's team. Number one, brother, the financial empire, all the wealth, all the financial rewards that the multi-million dollar man has laid on everybody can be wiped out just in one day, brother.
But the things that we're fighting for aren't materialistic, brother. It's the love of these Hulkamaniacs. It's the trust of these Hulkamaniacs. And the fact that all these Hulkamaniacs are behind these four Hulkamaniacs, we're going to survive. These guys got to prove a point. They're the new tag team champions of the world. And to keep that reputation, they got to get by the powers of pain. I got something to prove to myself. I got to even up the score with a human wrecking machine. And just look at the burning eyes of the Snake Man, Jake.
You see, we have something to offer each other, and we're not talking about money. What we have to offer each other is the guarantee that we will be there when we are needed. Now, we're not Boy Scouts. You wouldn't walk out in front of me if I was driving a car. You wouldn't walk out in front of these guys if they were driving a truck. And you wouldn't step out in front of the Hulkster if he's laid back on a Harley doing 100 miles an hour. The biggest difference between us, the Hulkamaniacs, and the million-dollar team, DiBiase, Zeus, and the powers of pain, is that we're breathing fire, brother, and you guys are trying to blow smoke up our ass, this man right here.
And we don't like smoke, it ain't healthy for you, and neither are these. Hulk Hogan, Jake the Snake, we know who's the Zeus and the powers of pain better than anybody, and they don't care about anybody but themselves. Ted DiBiase, what are you going to do when one of us kicks your stinking teeth in the middle of the ring? And you go back to your corner to make a tag, and you wonder, did you give him enough money?
That's right. Smash and myself, we had a lot to prove over the last 6 months. Were we worthy to regain these championship belts? We proved it. Now we have a big task ahead. Are we worthy to tag up with this man? The honorary Hulkamaniacs. Face Foods the Stooge, the Million Dollar Men. You can't buy these belts. You can't buy determination. You can't buy loyalty. And you can't buy us. Hulk Hogan, we're behind you 150%. Wherever you go, we're going. You know something, brother love? That's the point. Been trying to prove all along, and I'm gonna repeat it one more time just so you'll understand it. You live by the buck, you die by the buck, brother. And if you're a Hulkamaniac, you learn to survive, and that's just what we're gonna do, brother.
We'll find out who survives Thanksgiving night.
And speaking of hot ones, here he comes.
Santana, senor. It's not that I think that Santana is nothing. It's just that I know Mr. Perfect is more. Ladies and gentlemen, y otra pobrecitos, con su permiso, Mr. Perfect.
Now you got to admit something, man.
What?
Mr. Perfect is showing a lot of guts with this perfect record on the line.
Perfect to lock up with Tito Santana.
What a great matchup this is going to be, because both of these guys, excellent, extraordinary, great scientific wrestlers. But I think Perfect has the advantage.
Why?
Because he's also great at roughing it up.
Quick go behind, Mr. Perfect. Santana? Ooh, easily.
Eventually breaking up with an elbow. Aha, drop toe hold missed by Mr. Perfect.
And it don't help having the genius. I mean, it does help, I should say, having the genius outside the ring.
Not if you're Tito Santana, does it? Santana, I sure would be tempted to let the genius have one of my flying forearms. Nice shoulder block by Santana. Right back at Mr. Perfect. And, whoa, yeah, look at that. What a hip toss.
And wow, did you see Mr. Perfect spin a 360 on that mat?
Mr. Perfect taking a little siesta here. Trying to break the momentum of Tito Santana.
Both of these guys, consummate wrestlers.
Kind of reminds you of yourself years ago, huh, Jess?
Yeah, I got a great memory. I used to do many of them moves, McMahon.
Really? Santana back to the corner. Ref asking for the clean break. Santana shoves himself out of there. Look at this. Two bulls in there. Oh, come on! Right over the referee's shoulder.
What's the matter with that?
He saw it.
Saw an opening, he took advantage of it.
Mr. Perfect trying to wear down Tito Santana. Back to the feet, a chop to the throat.
Something you got to remember, McMahon. You have to defend yourself at all times in there.
Now we're seeing some of those roughhouse tactics you alluded to earlier on, Jesse. By the way, we spoke with Mr. Perfect earlier on as well. He was accompanied by that man, the genius.
Tito Santana, you're finding out why I have a perfect record. And when it's all over, you'll know why they call me Mr. Perfect. And in a very short time to come, me and my perfect record will completely destroy you, Hulk Hogan.
Genius doesn't like what he's seeing. Santana in control, face first to the buckle.
With a handful of hair, I might add.
Perfect is going to be in something less than perfect shape come this Thursday Survivor Series. Here it comes. Tito Santana setting up for the flying forearm to the rope. Oh, there it is. Roll over the top rope goes Perfect. Santana hitting so hard, he went over the top rope.
And that's actually a Chico, because if Perfect would have stayed in the ring, Chico probably could have got the three count, but he hit him so hard, sent him out to the floor, gives Mr. Perfect a chance to recoup from that big forearm.
Santana pulling Perfect up. Tries to set him up now for the suplex and bring him in. Yes, the hard way. Going for the cover now.
Foot on the rope. Foot on the rope.
Oh, come on.
Come on what? We have rules, you know, McMahon.
How lucky can you get? Santana justifiably frustrated at the moment with Mr. Perfect. Oh, no, look at that.
Thumb to the eye. It'll stop anybody.
Now Perfect reversing things on Santana. Chopping, hammering away to Tito. Trying to set him up now. No, reversal by Santana. Back body. No, look out. Mr. Perfect.
Hard-fought victory for...
some very fast company this Thursday night.
Yes.
Big Boss Man is the captain, of course, of the Enforcers with Akeem, Rick Martel, and the Honky Tonk Man.
Yeah, but speaking of fast company, here it comes, Jack.
I love it.
Dream is business, as he says. And right away, Akeem and the Slickster take a powder. As long as the American Dream has the Big Boss Man's billy club in his hand, he has a little something extra going for him, to say the least. He'll need that something extra as he heads to Survivor Series this Thursday as the Dream Team meet the Enforcers, as you brought out earlier on. And, of course, Dusty Rhodes joining the likes of Brutus the Barber Beefcake, Red Rooster, and Tito Santana on his team.
Whole lot of wrestling talent right there. Wow. Maybe I could be a member of that team, Vinny, or you for that matter. I'd like
that.
To be on a team. How about it? We get you on a team?
I'd like to kind of be observing from a distance, if you know
okay.
what I mean. Yeah. Right now, Akeem is getting a first-hand look at the Dream.
You can't afford to make a mistake with Akeem, because if he drops on you, forget about it. It's curtains.
Uh-oh. I think we're finding out here that Akeem likes to show us his moves, but he's being outmoved, so this big... Watch from behind!
Look out!
Akeem hammering away. The rest of the Enforcers will be hammering away this Thursday. Akeem missing. Here now, I believe the Enforcers standing by.
This Thursday night at Survivor Series, it won't be a one-on-one situation. It'll be a team effort.
Yes, and we got it all together. Glass the bronze tie.
Bottom line, the Dream Team's nothing but fools following a thief. The Enforcers know how to handle fools and thieves. The Enforcer style. Count on it. Tough to pick a winner in that one, I'll tell you that.
Sure is, indeed.
African Dream was down on the canvas.
Oh, wait just a minute. Come on, ref. The Dream having his problems now is Akeem. All it takes is one or two blows from someone that big, and it could turn a match around in a half a second.
Well, Vince, you know in Survivor Series, you're going to have to deal with the Slickster at ringside. You're going to have to deal with the Colonel, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart at ringside. Those are decided advantages.
I suppose so. And again, the weight of Akeem down on the shoulders of Dusty Rhodes. Working in the trapezius area, and the Dream starts to make his move. Back to his feet now. Akeem digging in a little bit more.
Digging in on that trapezius area. Look at that, forced him right.
Oh, what's a slick for heaven? That's a Dusty Rhodes fan if I ever saw one. Look at that t-shirt. The headband, the whole thing.
Slickster was in trouble. He was backing up.
Yeah. Slickster get himself in a little trouble.
The Dream's in trouble as well.
He's back again. Talking to that same lady. And whether or not the Dream heard her, I don't know. But maybe you can hear this capacity crowd. He's making his move. Dusty Rhodes back to one knee. And now back to his feet, trying to turn into the hold. Relieve a little bit of pressure there. And Dusty Rhodes trying to measure. Yeah, there he goes.
Going downstairs in the breadbasket. Might be the weak spot on the big guy. Oh, right in the kisser.
Out of the side of the head, Akeem leveling Dusty Rhodes. And when you're downstairs looking up, what is going on around ringside?
She's still bad-mouthing her. She bought a ticket. She doesn't have to sit down. She can do anything she likes.
That's for sure.
What a heavy man you mean!
Wait just a minute. Akeem is coming out trying to intimidate this lady.
Yeah, you need to do that.
Just because she's a Dusty Rhodes fan.
Here comes a Dream.
Dream is coming out as well. Oh, my, what a chop. Akeem down. Dusty Rhodes back in the ring. Wait a minute. Akeem's been counted out. Dusty Rhodes is the winner. Akeem is hot.
Well, they got all wrapped up with that lady at ringside and cost him the match.
And Dusty Rhodes really going to
Well, you can bet if that's any indication of what the Dream Team is going to do to the Enforcers on Thanksgiving night in Chicago.
No, I think they're going to take that polka-dotted buffoon and make him wish he'd never stole that.
Easy for you to say that sitting here.
He knows better than to come here and mess with me. Yeah. He'd have to answer to the family.
Let me reinforce once again, folks, that here we are, Monday night, and it's this coming Thursday night, Survivor Series at the Rosemont in Chicago. The only way you're going to be able to see it, the only way you're going to be able to be part of it, is pick up your phone and call your local cable company and find out how you can partake of pay-per-view and be part of Survivor Series. I don't want to hear it next week that I got left out, I didn't call in time.
I need four tickets.
You stop with the tickets. There are no tickets available. Pay-per-view? You got a dish in your backyard? No. You got a de-scrambler? No. Then you're not going to see it at all, are you?
I'll be there. Oh. I don't have to see it. I'll be there.
Right now, let's take a look at where the WWF is headed.
Say, what an absolutely stunning presentation that is that the model is wearing. Believe me, he is making such an impression upon the world of high fashion. This is his stud patrol look. The model never wears a leisure suit, even less a bowling shirt. He is a man of principle. Recently I heard him say, I'll wear high fashion, or absolutely not a thing. The model proves that a super masculine physique is no impediment to dressing correctly. He's always dressed for success. Yes, the model was truly born to be chic.
Yes, sir. I am the face of the 90s. Yes, sometimes it's so hard to be beautiful. The French accent, the good looks. I'm so hot, I'm cool. And you know what? If looks could kill, I'd be called Jack the Ripper. So from now on, observe at your own risk.
It appears that not everyone agrees that the model is the paragon of fashion that he claims. One of those being Brutus the Barber Beefcake. We will be eager to see what will occur in the weeks to come. For the World Wrestling Federation, this has been Special Report.
Tunnel to Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart went out to pick out the biggest man in the audience to sit upon the back of Dino Bravo to show you what kind of strength this particular individual possesses. Let's go now and take you as we join this in progress.
Dave, you, come on.
My hometown favorite, look at it.
Yes, I can.
Okay, hey, Jesse, take a look at the size of this man.
Yeah, that's impressive, Dino Bravo. That
does look pretty big, but I got to see him when he gets in the ring, McMahon. Then we'll get a little more perspective. I mean, he may only be 4 foot 11.
For Canadian strongman, Dino Bravo.
He is the world's strongest man. And like I said, baby, anybody in the audience, the people wanted this guy, let's bring him down, man.
I assume you're from West Virginia.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yeah, he talks like West Virginia.
Turn around here. John, do I dare ask how much you weigh?
460 pounds.
Wait a minute. 460 pounds?
Yes, sir.
All right, Jimmy Hart, Dino Bravo.
This is one time when Jimmy Hart's mouth has really gotten Bravo into trouble. Big trouble.
Right now. As he... The crawl position.
See, now he's measuring off. He's getting his arms in the right position.
For this big man from West Virginia, John, to sit on his back. We're going to see if he can do a push-up. One, two, three, four. I can't believe it.
Well, I'm impressed. I'm impressed.
You better be.
I'll tell you what, that was some feat of strength on the part of Dino Bravo.
The weight of this man is 460 pounds. 460 pounds. John, go right ahead. Go right ahead. All right, he is up there. Okay, Ultimate Warrior. What? What's this?
He just gave
Wait a minute.
Whoa! Bravo! Following through an elbow.
The Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, the Colonel, he must think everyone was born yesterday. Hey, Doodler, are you part of this program, or what are you doing?
Negotiating. I'm doing some contracts.
Negotiating.
Contractual work.
You don't have many family members. Studio B.
You have family members.
He doesn't have many guys left in the Heenan family, does he?
Who could possibly want to negotiate with you now that you've lost everything that you've had? All your champions are gone. Who would be possibly want to negotiate with you?
You know, you're trying to rub it in every week.
Yeah,
because there's been a minor setback. But you see, the Bobby Heenan family and myself, we're big enough to overcome something like that.
Like how?
You consider losing the Intercontinental and the WWF Tag Team Championship belts a minor setback?
Yes, the way it was lost and what happened because of Rowdy Roddy Piper and because they beat the wrong man. But you wait till you see the tag team I've got with Andre the Giant and Haku. There's a tag team.
We'll be right back with that duo in just a moment.
And I'll introduce them. Don't count me down again, you moron.
Rod.
What does it say?
Well,
the loser with two O's?
Yeah, he spelled it wrong. What do you expect from the brain?
No. Yeah, he's the kind of guy that is a loser with two O's. And you know there's a capital L. I know how to spell.
Boobsy the brain strikes again.
I can write anything the way I want. That is a loser with two O's. I mean, we'll put another L, there'd be another L. I do like
your tag team, though.
Two S's.
I like the way Andre, the new giant Elmer Fudd of the WWF, the survival wearies, don't I like that.
Elmer Fudd needs
your help.
I'm going to tell him you called him Elmer Fudd.
You tell him that. You tell him RP himself said the Elmer Fudd of the WWF.
Here's a guy in the WWF who really tells it like it is.
Now.
A guy who never makes a mistake and has a great future here in the World Wrestling Federation, referring to my longtime personal friend, Sean Mooney.
Get me a phone.
And watch the powerful chicken wing is locked in. It's too late for his foe to fly the coop. The Red Rooster, a superstar with a lot to crow about.
Most unlikely challenger, the Genius. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of that title match.
Genius better watch out. Hogan's got that look in his eye.
Look at the look in the eye of the Genius. Genius moving back in and a hook to Arrow's face. What's the Genius going to do now? What kind of brain power is he going to use now, Jesse? A block and Hulkster ran. A fist into the head of the Genius.
You said it right, a fist.
And the foot. And dropped the leg, it'll be over. Mr. Perfect, a bit frustrated on the outside. Look at that, rake of the face. A rake down the back.
Now
another one.
The Genius is stooping to Hogan level.
What?
Exactly, he's going to Hogan's level of wrestling.
The Hulkster turning things back out. Hogan is just all over the Genius. The Hulkster again, as you said earlier, is frustrated to the max. Hogan with Genius in the middle of the ring. And whoa, all the way to the outside.
Now, what was the purpose for that? You're supposed to wrestle a man. You're supposed to try to pin a man, not permanently injure him by throwing him out of the ring.
The Hulkster obviously frustrated. Mr. Perfect now out there by the Genius.
What's this?
Hogan's taking it to the floor. Hogan better watch out. He better worry about the Genius and not bother with Mr. Perfect.
Genius back in. The Hulkster now coming back in. Wait a minute. Oh, my. Right into the head with a championship belt.
And the referee didn't see anything in the ring, McMahon. He didn't see it.
The referee has been counting the Hulkster out. Indeed, he did not see that, and I can't believe it.
Major upset. Reigns wins over Braun.
Count out the Genius.
Folks, if you think that was somewhat appalling, moments after the Genius scored a victory over Hulk Hogan in that title bout, I had a chance to talk to both Mr. Perfect and the Genius. I think you're going to find this somewhat disgusting.
I can't believe, ladies and gentlemen, what I am eyewitnessing in all my years of covering the World Wrestling Federation. Kurt Hennig, it is one thing for Hulk Hogan to lose by virtue of a countout to the Genius. It's another thing for you to desecrate the very meaning of Hulkamania.
This has never been a perfect belt, and Hulk Hogan, you're not a perfect champion. And I'll follow you around to every arena if I have to, and I'll destroy every belt until you give me a title shot the perfect way.
Right on the heels of that interview, I spoke with the World Wrestling Federation champion, an angry Hulk Hogan.
Millions of Hulkamaniacs will unite. The three commandments are still intact. And with the Hulkster leading the brigade, the only thing left for you, Mr. Perfect, is not perfection, but the ultimate encounter with Hulk Hogan equals the perfect defeat for you.
Entertainment System presents the Big Boss Man, Akeem, the Twin Towers. With a combined weight of over 800 pounds, this thriving metropolis is never kind to its tourists. And it's the Big Boss Man's wrecking ball for many who visit as they end up condemned properly.
Playing the Nintendo game WrestleMania.
They're not playing it, McMahon. You gotta be smarter than the game in order to play the game.
What an incredible fashion statement. Stop patrol look. Notice the effortless glide in his step. You'll never find the model wearing a leisure suit or a bowling shirt. He is a very principled man who believes strongly in what he's doing. The other day I heard him say, I'll wear high fashion or I will wear nothing at all. The model proves that having a super masculine physique is no impediment to dressing properly. For all occasions, he is always dressed for success. Here is a man with a stylish smile, and look at him. He has drop-dead good looks. Yes, the model was truly born to be chic.
Listen, I am the model. I am the face of the 90s. You know, it's so hard to be beautiful. You know, the French accent, the good looks.
Grunlow's going to show up in diapers this week, Jess.
Real funny, McMahon.
Oh, I enjoyed that last week.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Love. You were great last week.
Please welcome in this time my guest, Brother Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Yeah. All right, Greg the Hammer Valentine. Jimmy Hart,
welcome,
keep
brother.
Quiet. Thank you,
yes,
I will.
You two have got to be two of the most loving individuals I have ever seen. Why, after retiring Rugged Ronnie Garvin, you came back and reinstated him. How loving.
Well, you see, Brother Love, Greg the Hammer Valentine, he's a kind man. He's a great man. And most of all, he's a loving man. Stated Rugged Ronnie Garvin back in wrestling, baby.
You know, Brother Love, a lot of people thought that Greg the Hammer Valentine was foolish for reinstating Rugged Ronnie Garvin. They thought Jimmy Mouth of the South Hart was foolish for reinstating Rugged Ronnie Garvin. But no, we're not fools. The only reason Rugged Ronnie Garvin is back as a wrestler is because now I'm going to have him in that squared circle. I'm going to have him in that combat zone, and I can put that figure four leg lock on you, Rugged Ronnie Garvin, and listen to it go snap, crackle, and pop.
Oh, yes, and you know, Brother Hammer, I must say, how courageous that you are. While stepping into the ring, what with the injury to your shin and all, I know that you are injured, but yet you still can apply the figure four leg lock with such accuracy.
Oh, yes, Brother Love. My figure four leg lock is more powerful than it's ever been in my entire career. It's the most devastating figure four leg lock in the World Wrestling Federation today. What?
What's this?
What is the meaning of this? What the
you're also a stupid man. Yes, that figure four leg lock is a painful hole and a dangerous hole. But you've made two mistakes. The first one, you let your ego take control of you. And the second mistake, you put the figure four on me. Therefore, I want the president Jack Tunney. Because my ankle is hurt, and I ask permission to wear this here. You see this here? Now I can protect my leg from that hole of yours. And I'm going to tell you something.
American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the Big Boss Man. He's gonna pay big time now. Boss Man with a rope across the throat and chest of Dusty Rhodes. What do you say?
Go get the stick.
Ho ho! Now you're gonna see interrogation, McMahon. The Doctor of Style of Slickster has the Billy Club. He's stopped now. Upset of the outcome of that matchup, perhaps justifiably so. Let's pick up some comments.
No more distractions. None at all. I'm tired of fooling with you, boy. Dusty Rhodes, you're nothing but a scum. Common thief. So it's time for you to start serving a little hard time with a Big Boss Man's ball and chain style of justice. You can count on it. I'm going to hurt you, boy.
Concerned with, in addition to the prowess of one Dino Bravo.
So in other words, you're saying Bravo definitely is the favorite. That's not often that a challenger is the favorite against a champion.
Against those odds, I'd have to say so. Bravo with the cover and the three count. Fuller never stood a chance. The question is, will the Ultimate Warrior...
Here is your winner, the self-professed...
Look at this. What's he doing? Oh, my goodness.
Bravo.
Forget it. Did you see that?
That's exactly what he did to the Warrior.
Ha! 460 pounds moving in that ring and crashing down into the chest of Fuller. Let's go back and take a look at the replay.
Here you see Bravo. Look at the altitude he got on that elbow. Wham! Big side breaker right there. Look at the earthquake here. The Canadian earthquake. That's Pancake City, McMahon.
You got that right.
You know, speaking of a flat Ultimate Warrior, it just happens the Ultimate Warrior is on the front of the new WWF World Wrestling Federation 1990.
On Primetime Wrestling, because We're rapidly approaching the holiday season, and everyone knows that the World Wrestling Federation is putting on an extravaganza on Wednesday, December 27th. No holes barred. Let's make it a no holes barred Christmas inside the 15-foot-high steel cage. The Hulkster and his partner, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, taking on the Macho King, Randy Savage, along with the human wrecking machine Zeus, and somebody's going to get stuffed right through that cage.
Let me get this straight. You get to see the whole movie, No Holds Barred.
That's correct.
And the match inside the cage with Hulk Hogan on pay-per-view.
That's correct. Boy, does he have a tough time understanding that?
Well, I'm trying to make it simple for the humanoids out there. You know what Christmas means to them.
A lot of things.
Yeah, you know the guy outside the department store with the bell? They mug him.
Will you stop? Will you
Christmas
be serious?
To these people.
It's a serious time of the year. Hot Rod, I know that Christmas plays a very special role in your life.
Well, I love Christmas myself. I go out, I get into the festive season, I get Christmas trees, I get little balls to hang from and then lights and stuff like that. Bob, have you done any of your Christmas shopping yet?
Yes.
Do you do Christmas shopping?
And your present's on the way. Because it's ticking, don't worry about it.
Well, thank you. I feel bad because I didn't get you a damn thing.
I don't want anything from you.
He hasn't spent $3 in the last three Christmases that I know of. Debut time here on Primetime Wrestling. We're going to take a look at the earthquake.
Oh, I like Christmas. Earthquake.
Earthquake.
Knocked over everything here.
Knocked over everything.
Heck of a big guy, isn't he?
460 pounds, they said. Looks like over 500 to me.
He's a big guy. He's a
big
guy.
Did they do? Take him down and hook him up on the meat scale and let him hang there at the butcher's and weigh it? Hot Rod, where does someone like that go and get weighed?
I don't know. Where was it? West Virginia, they found him. You know, I got to admit, they fooled me. Dino Bravo fooled me. Jimmy Hart fooled me. We saw him sitting in there, and even the people themselves were clapping and saying, come on down and see if Dino Bravo can do push-ups. And all of a sudden, Ultimate Warrior got kind of crushed there. So the guy is not only big, the guy's got a little bit of brains to him, a little sense to him.
You know, that's not hard to believe that Piper was fooled. Fools get fooled, you know.
Are you going to start this week?
Or I'm sorry. Nice? I apologize.
No.
Please don't do that. It doesn't become you, Bobby.
Bigger.
It's going to be a rough week, I can tell.
It's Christmas.
Right now, we're going to take a look and see where the World Wrestling Federation will be headed in the very near future.
Tis the season.
That's Wednesday, December 27th, the big no-holes-barred Christmas present from the World Wrestling Federation. I was referring to something that took place just a short period of time ago, the desecration of the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt. I don't agree with that 100% or even 50%. Just because you can't have something doesn't mean that you go out and destroy it. Of course, you would think otherwise. We're going to bring you up to date right now and show you exactly what I'm talking about.
I can tell him.
Shut up.
Oh, my! Right into the head of the championship belt! And the referee didn't see anything in the ring, McMahon. He didn't see it. The referee has been counting the holster out. Major upset! Reigns wins over Braun!
Folks, if you think that was somewhat appalling, moments after the Genius scored a victory over Hulk Hogan in that title bout, I had a chance to talk to both Mr. Perfect and the Genius. I think you're going to find this somewhat disgusting.
I can't believe, ladies and gentlemen, what I am eyewitnessing. In all my years of covering the World Wrestling Federation, Kurt Hennig, it is one thing for Hulk Hogan to lose by virtue of a countout to the Genius. It's another thing for you to desecrate the very meaning of Hulkamania.
This has never been a perfect belt, and Hulk Hogan, you're not a perfect champion. And I'll follow you around to every arena if I have to, and I'll destroy every belt until you give me a title shot the perfect way.
Right. And as far as I'm concerned, Hot Rod, rightly so.
Well, you know, what people don't understand, I think, sometimes is a belt like that, the blood and the sweat that has gone in to regaining, maintaining a belt like that is second to none. You can't realize how much effort you put into it, how many times at 6 o'clock in the morning you've got up, and the heart that you put into it. And for somebody to come along and just willfully go and damage it and start smashing it just to try to get a title shot to incense him, that's a silly thing to do, because now, instead of just having a title shot, you got a real personal issue, and that's when it gets dangerous.
You know, another thing, that belt also represents all the little Hulksters to Hulk Hogan. That means a lot to him. And I would just like to say now, what I saw Mr. Perfect do there is a disgrace. He should have taken that belt and waffled Hulk Hogan with it. And all the little Hulksters. It's Christmas.
You wouldn't know anything about it. You don't have any belts anymore.
Watch your Christmas spirit there, boobs.
Here's a guy that's destined to have a belt someday, Rugged Ronnie Garvin. He really,
Sure, after the man's out cold, it's pretty easy to stomp a guy. Cheap way to get a victory. Tony Schiavone, check out his notes a little bit.
What do you mean check out his notes?
He made reference to the movie No Holds Barred starring Hulk Hogan.
Well, so?
Tony, the star is Zeus.
Will you
get that straight?
Zeus was not the star. Hulk Hogan was the star. Hot Rod, who was the star of the movie No Holds Barred?
Well, now, I haven't seen the movie myself, but I saw a big, huge marquee with a guy with a tan and blonde hair and big pythons on him and yellow boots. That fella's the star of the movie.
Hulk Hogan.
See, he don't even know the guy's name. You're asking an illiterate?
I'm asking a man
well, you're gonna see when
knows
Zeus
a lot of things about a lot of things, unlike you.
Can I ask you something, boobs?
Sure, go ahead.
When was the last time you saw Zeus with blonde hair?
When was the last time you saw Zeus without a tan?
Not nice, Bob.
We're going to be back in just a moment with Paul Roma.
He looks good, the guy. He's in shape.
Have a match that we're going to join in progress, and I, for one, it's from Toronto. I, for one, am glad we're going to join it in progress because it's Paul Roma against Boris Zukov, and we don't got to listen to Boris sing the Russian national anthem. Thank the Lord for small favors. So we're going to start this thing in progress, see that young Italian stallion against the Russian, and we'll just see what they can do. Ooh, could be a good time. In progress. No tune.
Is a game of congregation in the union of the body and the mind. While Mr. Perfect's busy making ringer after ringer, Hulk Hogan looks like one big horse behind.
I wonder if there's anything I can't do perfectly. No way. I know one thing I can do perfectly, and that's take the World Wrestling Federation Championship from you, Hulk Hogan. Like everything else in my life, I'm a dead ringer at it. You know, genius, I am perfect in every way. You know something else?
Hulk Hogan.
You can't do that.
This contest is scheduled for...
Well, we've got another ringer.
Coming down the aisle.
Here's a ringer, all right, on his way to the ring.
Absolutely, Hawk. He's definitely worth 3 points.
Something lately, McMahon.
What?
You've been getting your hair styled just like Honky.
What?
I look over at you, I see the same hairstyle that Honky's got.
No way. Look at that greasy kid stuff he puts on his hair.
The only thing is, you ain't got enough beard to grow sideburns.
Here's somebody that can grow anything he wants to grow.
Yeah, what a matchup this is going to be.
All right, Jesse, it's pick-up time.
Well, this is a tough pick-up because, you know, you can never understand totally how Stuka's going to react in the ring because the guy's an animal.
Ooh, look at that. Honky Tonk charging a super fly. And I believe that was a mistake. Snooker chops him down.
Well, the Superfly was definitely waiting on the Honky Tonk Man right there. He was ready for him.
Honky coming off, and Snooker buries the right hand. Headbutt. And Honky Tonk
paying for the early attack.
Now what Hawkey ought to do right here is jump out of the ring and get with Jimmy Hart.
Look at the kick by Snuka. A chop by Snuka. Snuka sets him up. Superfly now using the ropes. Double chop to the throat and down goes the Honky Tonk Man.
Now we'll see what the Superfly can take from the Honky Tonk Man. The only problem is Honky's going after.
Whoa. And once again, Snuka's in control. To the rope. Over the Honky Tonk Man. Snuka right back at him. Oh, come on, Jimmy Hart. Snuka going out. Now he's out there by Jimmy Hart. Honky Tonk from behind down across Snuka.
See, the Superfly wasn't paying attention. Ooh.
Honky Tonk back in before the count. Oh, yeah. Shake right in the middle. You like that, huh?
He always has time for his fans, no matter where the action's at.
Snuka dazed by the tactics of the Honky Tonk Man.
No, Snuka brought it upon himself. He decided to go outside the ring and chase Jimmy Hart.
Only after Jimmy Hart and interfere in the match. Headbutt by Snuka.
Oh, yeah. Jimmy's real powerful. He can really interfere a lot, can he?
He can pull an ankle. We saw that earlier. Headbutt by Snuka.
Come on, Hawkey, watch him, baby, come on.
Superfly has been late, really on a tear. Then again, the same can be said of the Honky Tonk Man.
Now you got him, now we're rolling, we're rolling.
See, Honky's smart right there. He's not going after the head of the Superfly. He goes to the midsection, goes to the back of the neck. You want to stay away from Superfly's head. He's got a thick skull.
There, the top rope on the throat of Snuka.
And I don't care how tough you are, your throat's always a vulnerable spot.
Superfly snapped off the ropes.
There you got it, now you got it, Hawkey. That's it, baby.
Hawkey's are pretty much in control, as the strength has indeed been sapped from Superfly Snuka.
Hawkey made a mistake there. He went after Snuka's head, and he's paying for it.
He just kicks Snuka in the head. So that no effect either. Another one.
Sometimes you learn the hard way.
I don't think I'd want to be hammering someone in the head and have them come up barking like Snuka did. I think that just might frighten me a bit. Ooh, look at that, though. To the midsection, and that definitely took its toll on Snuka.
McMahon, it wouldn't take much at all to frighten you.
Okay, battle to the Superfly again, flying in the air. Snuka has the Honky Tonk Man up, down to the knee and down to the canvas. Oh, now Superfly Man, yes, he's looking at the corner.
He's taking too much time. No, he should get up there if he's going to go for it.
Snuka going to the outside, and Jimmy Hart's baiting him. Oh, no. Oh, no. Superfly! Cover! I can't believe what I'm seeing. Honky Tonk blasted Snuka twice with the guitar. It had no effect, and Honky Tonk is getting out of there.
Take a beating like that from the
Hunt. And he has a different attitude than Gorbachev. I believe me.
Who cares?
I just told you that. It's my job.
Now how
here
would you know
journalist.
What Gorbachev's attitude is?
He doesn't.
I mean, you don't. You read the funny papers. Let's get serious now. The reason.
I'm up on current events.
Okay. Oh, who's Barney Frank?
He sings that song.
So the reason,
you know.
The reason that Boris gets along with Nikolai a little better in the ring is because Nikolai instills confidence. You know, you're only as good as the people you're with. But if you're with somebody really, really good, they boost your confidence level. That's why the boy does better in tag teams.
Outstanding See? Feature that we haven't talked about yet this week. Superfly Jimmy Snuka taking Wrestling Federation. Brutus the Barber Beefcake will have a date with destiny as he joins forces with a Hulkster in a 15-foot-high steel cage against the Macho King, Randy Savage, and the human wrecking machine, Zeus. And it's going to be a happening.
I'm just wondering.
You've been wondering for the last 5 years. What is it? Go ahead.
Just wondering where Hogan is going to hide.
Hide?
Yes, he's scared to death of Zeus. Everybody knows it. Zeus unscrewed his head the last time he got his hands on him. There's no place to hide in the cage.
Wait till you see what kind of condition Brutus is in.
Well,
gifts have all been opened. You've still got Wednesday, December 27th to look forward to. One more gift.
That's
and Brutus
right.
is ready.
Well, he's not going to cut any hair on Zeus. We know that.
That's obvious.
And he's not going to get his hands on the Macho King Randy Savage. He's not going to lay his hands on Sherry. He's going to be too busy trying to get Hogan out from behind him.
Are you misinformed?
I am not.
This is an all-out, knock-down, drag-out affair. No holes barred. You know what that means? You know what the rules are? There are no rules.
Well, I knew that.
Hot Rod, dangerous type of match.
I don't think anybody's going to be worried about cutting any hair in this type of match right now. When you got people inside a steel cage, it's one of my Fortois steel cages. What you got there is you got people ramming heads, and you got people trying to make a point. This thing has been building and building and going on, and it's time to stop Zeus right now while we can. Otherwise, he's going to grow into a monster nobody's going to be able to control. The finale is a steel cage match.
Here's a guy they say belongs in a steel cage, Sean Moon.
Presents Dino Bravo and the Canadian Earthquake. With hurricane force, the strongman drives his adversary to the canvas. And a powerful earthquake measures a 10 on the Richter scale. For their opponents, these two are natural disasters.
Someone's career could be terminated in this steel cage match on Wednesday, December 27th. No.
Let me introduce this next one.
Why do you want to introduce
Because it has to be done right.
What do you mean it has to be
it's
done?
It's very important.
We do everything right here on primetime. There's at least 8 or 9 matches every week here.
You do 9 of them then. Let me do this one. I have to do this one.
Go ahead. Be my guest.
Where am I? Which camera?
Right here.
Ladies, get up to the set. And
ladies?
Get
we have
now, wait a minute.
They're
starting to switch cameras on me. Ravishing Rick Rude is coming into your home. I mean, you're going to see him take a rooster apart. I didn't have enough time.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. About to enter the arena with his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 252 pounds. Ravishing Rick Rude.
A capacity crowd on hand in Market Square Arena as Ravishing Rick Rude being led in by Bobby the Brain Heenan. A chorus of boos. A very smug look on Ravishing One's face as he makes his way in. Quite an entrance, Lord Alfred Hayes.
Absolutely, but what a wrestler this man has turned out to be. What a record he's got. You could say second to none, but then again, there is Mr. Perfect, who has a great record too. But look at this man.
Little discussion going on here.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat.
There's a nice looking gentleman.
Out of shape.
Yes, looks a bit like Rick Rude.
Indianapolis idiots.
Whoa.
Keep the noise down while I take my robe off and show the ladies what they've been dying to see. Hit the music.
I think that lady in the front row there is going to faint.
I think so. She was very, very impressed with the masculinity of this man, Ravishing Rick Rude. Oh, wow.
She certainly is really enjoying the pre-match festivities here on behalf of Ravishing Rick Rude, but it's going to be a fight here in Indianapolis.
This opponent, from Vero Beach, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, the Red Rooster.
The Red Rooster, Ravishing. Ravishing Rick Rude, and what a great match. There you see some Rooster fans set to go in this event. It should be tremendous. You know, Lord Alfred, a lot has gone on in the wars of the WWF, especially between one Ravishing Rick Rude and Rowdy Roddy Piper. And one can only wonder that because of what has transpired, if Rude has all his attention now on Red Rooster.
He certainly better have all his attention on the Rooster, because the Rooster is a tremendous wrestler. He moves at an alarming rate in the ring. He has some very, very special tricks that he can perform that will have you on your back and out of this match in no time short.
As the chant of Weasel rings out here, the Red Rooster, that's well documented, knows all about Bobby the Brain Heenan. Heenan, very upset, arguing with the referee up on the apron of the ring. But you get what you deserve, I guess, in the WWF, as the Rooster gets pushed right back up against the ropes. And Rude does a little pose here. However, even though, Alfred, you said his attention should be on the Red Rooster, anytime you have a run-in or have problems, I would think, with Rowdy Roddy Piper, you're vulnerable, because Piper is apt to run in to get you anytime, anywhere, from any part of the building, if he's around.
You're absolutely right, and I'm sure that idea lurks in the back of the mind of Heenan, as well as, of course, Ravishing Rick Rude. And Heenan is keeping a lookout there. You saw him dropping his fingers on the side of the ring. He must be very worried about that, too.
Many fans are chanting the name of Rowdy Roddy Piper. You can hear right here in the Market Square Arena. There's the headlock applied. Rooster trying his best to get out of it, but Ravishing Rick Rude keeps it clamped on. Now, trying maybe to power his way out. The Rooster trying to pull on the arms here. Up he goes. Can he get out? A very muscular Rude seems very confident, but the Rooster is almost out of it. No, down he goes again. A side headlock. And the Brain continues to complain at ringside.
Rude has tremendous upper body strength. And right now, the Rooster is playing into that upper body strength, but he's evolved with another way of tackling that. So maybe he's had a regrouping of his ideas.
Into the turnbuckle, into the corner. Rude hit very hard. The Brain trying to get his athlete to pick up the momentum here if possible. But no, it's all Red Rooster right now. A determined look on the youngster's face as he goes after Rude again. Here he goes one more time to the corner again. Face first to the middle of the ring with the Rooster. They have it all going his way here. Pulls him on the head.
And Rude in a lot of trouble here. The Rooster really putting his authority on this match. He's made some astoundingly good moves. And Rude is realizing suddenly that this belt is in danger for him.
The fans are really on Bobby the Brain Heenan. He had some heated words into the ring. I'm not so sure if it was at the referee, at the Red Rooster, or even at his athlete, Ravishing Rick Rude. But right now, the Rooster's on top of the situation.
Well, you hear the people chanting, Piper, Piper, Piper. Piper, you know where he's at. If you want to piece him, just stroll down the ring and get right in. But you're not man enough to do anything like that, Piper. You're yellow underneath that skirt. We'll be back in a moment. Piper. Piper, Piper. But I want you to listen real carefully now as we go back to this match, because you're going to hear everybody yelling, Rude, Rude, Rude. Well, not everybody. Myself and that Barbie doll in the front row.
The Red Rooster continues his assault on Ravishing Rick Rude. Rude trying to get up here. Oh, that time using the quickness, rolled around, and that ended that for the Red Rooster. Great move, Lord Alfred Hayes.
That really was. I don't think he expected to get such a devastating result from it. However, it's taken its toll on Red Rooster, and suddenly this whole belt has taken another turn, another swing, entirely in the direction of Ravishing Rick Rude.
If his attention was with Roddy Piper, Ravishing Rick Rude, it's turned now towards the Red Rooster and the effort at hand. There's a reverse atomic drop, and I know many of the fans here in Indianapolis will not let Rude forget Rowdy Roddy Piper. Many of those chanting the name of Piper, the rowdy one, but still Rude has a battle on his hands.
And Rude measuring every blow now. He performed that reverse atomic drop with such precision. It was really a classic move. And Rooster has got to try and hold him
Right now, as you hear the chorus of boos, you saw Bobby the Brain directing traffic from the outside. You know, Rude has contended, and so has the Brain, that the actions of Rowdy Roddy Piper has made Rude even more vicious, more intense. What do you think about that?
No, I believe that to be true. I really do. Piper has spurred this man to a lot more intensity, and that often happens in wrestling.
Right now, the intense Ravishing Rick Rude continues with the forearm blows on the back of the neck of the Red Rooster as you take a good look. The penal, oh, right hand or maybe a left hand, I don't know. But it apparently came from Bobby the Brain Heenan, and it nailed the Red Rooster on the side of the head.
And all that happened, of course, while the attention of the referee was being diverted by Rude. And, you know, when you're in against Rude and Heenan, it's almost like working against a tag team.
You're exactly right, Alfred. Right now, the front face lock is applied, and the Rooster trying to get out of it. He was shaken up, not only from the assault from Ravishing Rick Rude, but from Bobby the Brain Heenan, as you see right there.
Tremendous camera work by our men here on the outside of the ring, the unsung heroes of the World Wrestling Federation. They take you right inside the ring there for a great, great close-up of the way Rude is punishing the Rooster.
And they'll take him right inside of the steel cage on December 27th on pay-per-view for No Holds Barred, the match, and of course, the movie starring Hulk Hogan. As the Brain now looks out to the fans at ringside, many still chanting the name of Rowdy Roddy Piper, trying to help now get the Red Rooster back into this, and here he comes. He is up with an elbow. Once again, the Rooster to the midsection, but no, Rude still on top of things here. Here we go with a ride to the far side ropes. This is a clothesline. That time, the Rooster with a clothesline of his own. Caught Rude, and Rude's up with the knees. And once again, the quickness of Ravishing Rick Rude comes into play.
It did indeed. He is so fast. When he moves with such certainty, but with such speed that there's not much an opponent can do against it. And that time he really caught Rooster, and again he catches him with another punishing move.
Drops him down on the midsection using the knee. He goes right after the Rooster one more time. Here we go, sends the Rooster in. Nice forearm shiver that time right to the midsection.
In the beginning of this match, Tony, everything was going the Rooster's way. His offense was absolutely total. He was blotting out everything that Rude did. But now I'm afraid the fortunes of war swung against him. Up! Oh, I spoke too soon!
Down goes Ravishing Rick Rude out of the ropes. The Rooster, the fans erupt on that. Bobby the Brain apparently concerned now as the right hand hits the side of the head. Rooster ducks low. And yes, an atomic drop. You see in the background, the Rooster is really fired up. Knee lift. The Red Rooster may be trying for the chicken wing in a matter of moments. He missed a clothesline. Oh, great move by Rude. Rude picks him by the head and gets on. The Rude awakening. Nicely done, and that's going to be it. Tremendous win out of nowhere for Ravishing Rick Rude.
Here is your winner, Ravishing Rick Rude.
A most impressive victory there by Ravishing Rick Rude. The fortunes of war swung each way several times for these men, and let us see exactly how Rude finished him off. What tremendous thinking this was, and what opportunism he showed here. Look at that Rude awakening, so devastating. He just has to lean back on him for that 1-2-3.
The battle is won by Ravishing Rick Rude, but the war continues with Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Admit it, Brain. You're very fortunate to come out of there with a victory.
Now, Rooster's a tough character. That's because of everything he picked up from me. But he's not in the same category as Ravishing Rick.
He gave Rude everything Rude wanted. True or false?
He gave him everything he wanted, including a three count.
Please. What'd you do? Have to sell all your clothes to go out and buy some Christmas gifts?
What do you mean?
Get the same jacket on there as you have on now?
I happen to own 12 of everything, and I don't buy Christmas gifts.
Hot Rod, do you believe that for a moment?
I enjoy his taste. Everything is in black. That's good. It's called mourning.
How many
it's what you're
do
going
you
to
own?
Need is mourning. You know what bothers me, Boobs, is every time I see you and Ravishing Rick Rude, you're always blowing kisses and swiveling your hips at me. You know, if you do that, I saw with the Red Rooster, there. There you go again, swiveling them hips and blowing them kisses. And somebody says, his intensity has increased. Brother, you better get some intensity when you come and fight me, because I ain't going beyond nothing to beat this guy. I don't care what it takes. I don't care. I did see one fan cheer for you. It had a big sign, Boobsy the Weasley. I saw that out there.
That's not the Red Rooster. That's the Legend Killer. Right now, we're going to take you to Mean Gene Oklurland, and he's with an individual that's having nightmares over a dream.
Please welcome
matter of fact, we had an occasion a little bit earlier on to speak with the Macho King and Queen Sensational Sherry.
Whistling a commoner at this very second, just like you, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Oh, yeah. One of the great things about being the Macho King is I sit way up there on my throne, wearing my crown and my scepter, and look down on all you small people like you, Duggan, and there ain't nothing you can do about it. Isn't that right? Dig it!
That remains to be seen. Savage with Roma. Oh, yeah. Roma, a savage way up. We're going to see a power slam head of steam into the canvas. Roma quickly to the outside. And this is an extraordinary athlete here in Paul Roma.
This is going to be a great, great
match.
He's got the king in trouble.
And going for Sherry.
Oh, that's a real manly thing to do, ain't it, McMahon?
Hey, listen, just like Hacksaw Jim Duggan told Sherry, she wants to act like a man, he's going to treat her like one.
Hey, Hacksaw.
Roma! Oh, my, too bad.
McMahon, Hacksaw Jim Duggan wouldn't know any other way to treat a woman.
Wow. Savage in control at the moment. The cover of Paul Roma, the kick out. Roma over the top rope to the outside.
Roma's going to pay the king and queen now. You can bet on that.
Oh, look at that. And you want to know why Roma was going to go after Sherry earlier?
Roma started it.
Sure he did.
He certainly did. What, are you blind? He went after her first. She's just defending herself.
Snapping over Roma.
The great thing about Sherry is...
in the chest. Be quiet.
She's capable of defending herself, and don't you ever tell me to be quiet, McMahon. I'll hit a person wearing glasses. You can count on it.
I don't wear glasses. Savage winding up with a right hand. And Roma taking the full brunt of the attack in the moment.
Yeah, just like you don't wear a toupee.
Well.
Kind of speechless, huh? Roma's kind of speechless right now with the Macho King.
Look at that maneuver by Roma, dropkick! Tremendous vertical leaping ability by Paul Roma. This man is a sensational athlete.
I won't doubt that.
And
he certainly is.
Pound, one of the stronger individuals in the entire World Wrestling Federation. Oh, come on! Look what Sherry did.
That'll teach him to mess with the queen.
It's bad enough you have to compete with the tactics and antics of the Macho Man, let alone the double-teaming effect of that person.
If he hit
it from high above, yes, elbow drops to the throat.
It's over.
And a hooky leg, yes indeed. Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Here is your winner.
Possessed this week.
Yeah, she's possessed with the king.
We're looking forward to December 27th, the presentation, the match, the movie, No Holds Barred.
The match, Hulk Hogan and Brutus the Barber Beefcake versus the human wrecking machine, Zeus, and the Macho King, Randy Savage.
Wow, he just snapped the champ's neck.
Hogan could be the first one eliminated.
Look at this, a blatant chokehold. Right in the center of the ring. Trying to stop Zeus, but there may be no stopping this human wrecking machine.
Zeus is possessed with simply destroying Hogan.
That's not the referee's job to do that.
And Zeus is letting them know about it, firing them.
I think Zeus is out of there.
Been dis-
Hogan should thank that referee for saving him, Gorilla. He won't be able to get away with this December 27th inside the steel cage.
Gentlemen, it's going to be a no-holds-barred Christmas, Wednesday, December the 27th, in a 15-foot-high steel cage. You two are going to be facing the human wrecking machine, Zeus, and, of course, the Macho King, Randy Savage, in a steel cage, Brutus.
Hey, well, cut my legs off and call us both Shorty, brother. Brutus the Barber Beefcake pulled his team through. They're survivors. The Hulkster's brother, the Maniacs. We proved that we're survivors, but on this no-holds-barred Christmas, brother, I just want all the Maniacs to know that it's different than any other cage match in the WWF. We're going out to win this match in this 15-foot-high, 15-foot-wide steel-tempered cage, but we're also going out there, Barber, to put those two, the Macho King and the Zeus, out of the WWF. But after what went down out there tonight, Brutus, it doesn't seem like this might be our kind of match, brother. The way the human wrecking machine was choking me down, the way he went crazy, the way he was pushing his own team around, it looked like he could manhandle anybody in the arena. That's why, Brutus, you're going to have to keep the steel-tempered clippers close by the cage, brother.
I saw them chink any armor tonight, Brutus.
Well, you know something, that Zeus, he was out of control, Mean Gene. I saw him trying to virtually rip the head right from the Hulk's shoulders. Oh, he tried to tear his head.
Oh, wait a minute.
Right
on. Just a second.
What's he doing?
You're the sole survivor, and you beefcake. What are you going to do when there's no holes barred?
What was that? Look out, it's pandemonium in the locker room.
I love it.
I don't believe this. Let's get some guys in there. Let's get some control. Let's get some security.
It's no hold barred on Thanksgiving, Gorilla.
It's just beginning. Right now, we're going to take a short break here while we try to maintain some order.
The model, Rick Martel, shines with boyish charm as he parades before thousands of appreciative fans.
Take a good look, yeah. You know, there's definitely a fashion crisis in America today. And out of the goodness of my heart, I will donate my services as a professional model and as a fashion consultant to help raise the level of fashion awareness. So now observe carefully, but don't get too excited.
The model is so wonderfully correct in his observations. Excitement, by Jove, is always in the air, especially when he exhibits the extremely fashionable lines of his choice of apparel for today. My goodness, what an aura emanates from Rick Martel. Coordination of pattern, line, and color have always been his forte. Here with this masculine chemise, he shows such refined taste in the world of haute couture.
You may hate to admit it, but you have to accept it.
Enough of us, let's take you now to the event center.
Dents, Dino Bravo, and the Canadian Earthquake. With hurricane force, the strongman drives his adversary to the canvas. And a powerful earthquake measures a 10 on the Richter scale. For their opponents, these two are natural.
Officially over, and the big boss man has been tossed the nightstick, and he's going to dish out a little punishment, a little justice, his style, to the sole survivors, Brutus Beefcake and the Dream Dusty Rhodes. Oh, look out, the nightstick! Thrown in by Slick!
The boss man's going to have the last laugh here, Gorilla.
Now watch a Slickster. He never does anything, Jess.
Hey, he's a little over-enthusiastic. What can I say, Gorilla? Ha-ha!
Just like that, the Slickster threw the big nightstick cannon. Big boss man is clobbered everyone.
Now he's going to read the dream, his rights, and do it for interrogation.
Referee goes down. That'll cost you some heavy dollars, my friend. This one is over, but Dusty Rhodes paying the price here.
Big Boss Man might have lost it, but Big Boss...
Oh, look at Brutus! He's got the hedge clippers! And the Boss Man and the Slickster cleared out of there in a hurry.
Got what you decided!
Here are your
wait to put her hands on Slick.
A hug from the Dream.
Oh, isn't that touching?
He's going to take her out of harm's way.
Something, man.
What?
You could have a tag team match right there. There's Rhodes and his partner, Slick and the Boss Man.
Come on, I don't think so.
Dusty Rhodes and his number one fan.
Look at this again.
There you see it. No reason for this. No reason for that person to strike the Slickster.
Let's take you now to the Event Center.
I love it. To have a no-holds-barred Christmas.
Why not?
Looks like he's already been down the chimney several times.
Deviation! My guest this week is a man who will not be humiliated! Brother Ravishing Rick Rude!
Oh, well, it's hot. He's angry. Just because... It was, let's see, I think Mr. Piper referred to it as dope on a rope.
So humiliated and went, brother.
That's right, you've never been humiliated. What Roddy Piper did to you, he humiliated himself.
I'm going to show you the height of humiliation. And that's a one. And that's a two. And what is that? That's a three.
With the people that love you, like myself and Mr. DiBiase and Ravishing Rick Rude. But if you want to talk about a gentleman who knows about humiliation, talk to Mr. Rude.
If you want to talk about humiliation, let's talk about the SummerSlam. Roddy Piper caused me to lose my Intercontinental title. If you want to talk about humiliation, let's talk about the bleach blonde bimbo who Piper paid to get in the ring and tell the world that I have stink breath. If you want to talk about humiliation, let's talk about what Piper did to you. Not just what he did to you, but how Piper stood here and told the world that he was gonna take a gunner. He's mad enough to come out here and put a diaper on Ravishing Rick Rude. Well, come on, Piper. If you're mad enough to do it, come on and try it. Shut up. Piper, one thing you've gotta know. As soon as you step down off your high horse and step into the ring with Ravishing Rick Rude, you've got to realize that the man who is about to defeat you is the very monster that you created.
Sure, you're going to see that, brother love. Then again, who knows?
Over in Studio B, Hot Rod himself.
Hello. Been doing some...
Why don't you, Rod, before we went on the air, folks, Hot Rod was really doing a number on the guitar. What musical talent...
Whoa.
He was beating up a guitar.
You weren't here. He was playing the guitar.
He can play a guitar.
Oh, you should have heard it.
Well, we have in our feature, we have a honky tonk man, and I just, you know, I'm one that I don't, a little bit musically inclined, and I just was tinkering on the guitar, you know. But why did you think I couldn't play the guitar, Boobs?
Well, I was under the impression
would
to play
you like
guitar,
to make
you had to
a
have some brains.
Bet?
Oh, you had to know chords and notes.
You wouldn't know anything about
talent. Would
you
like to make a little bet on it?
You should have heard the Christmas numbers he was doing earlier on.
Please. One thing I don't like is I'd rather listen to polkas played on 33rd from a 78 record than listen to Christmas songs.
Wait, now you don't like Christmas. What's wrong with Christmas songs?
Well,
I've been doing my Christmas
shopping. There's no beat to them. They have no message.
There's going to be a beat in a minute, and it's going to be me beating on you.
A bunch of snotty-nosed little kids.
You'll get fined for that, Gurr.
Yeah, I know that.
A bunch of snotty-nosed little kids sit out front of your house and annoy you singing Jingle Bells and Santa's coming to town.
Wait a second. Boobs. Are you trying to tell me, honestly, that when the festive season comes around and you hear outside Jingle Bells, Shotgun Shells, all that stuff, and those pretty little kids are out there singing, you're trying to tell me, honestly, that just doesn't kind of warm your heart up and make you feel good about yourself?
Well, it upsets me for one reason, because I live in Beverly Hills, and it's never cold out there. If it was cold, I could pour water on them, and they'd freeze.
You might have to go into your pocket, too, and
yeah, you have to tip those little rats?
Why, you
idiot. I can't believe you're like that. I can't
interesting
believe...
matchups this week here on Primetime Wrestling. Let's start things off with a dream. Federation, and the big score that he's got to settle, of course, is with the big boss man.
Well, I think Dusty Rhodes has bitten off a little bit more than he can chew.
You think so?
He's the common man. He's the common humanoid out there.
You wouldn't know anything about that.
No, I wouldn't. Dirty Nails has his name on one pocket and where he works on the other pocket. Why would you do that when you could have got an education and owned the company? Why would you want to push a broom when you can tell the guy with the broom what to do?
What's wrong? You know, you always talk about humanoids, Boobs. What's wrong? You know, that's the backbone of America, those people that are out there working hard. That's the backbone of America. You ought to be proud of those people. That way, sluffers like you can lay down and just tell a bunch of lies and get paid for it. Get
people to wrestle for you. Some people were designed to push a broom and clock in on a pay clock, and some people were designed to own the company. I'm sorry, I know my niche in life.
Not only that, if more of the Heenan family members would work, you'd be in better shape than you are right now. Let's take a look at where the day, December 27th, it'll all happen on pay-per-view, no holds barred, when the Macho King, Randy Savage, joins forces with the human wrecking machine, Zeus, as they take on the Hulkster himself, World Wrestling Federation champion, along with his partner, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. There'll be a lot of strutting and a lot of cutting being done on Wednesday, December 27th. Why are you pointing at
me? On the 27th, I understand Savage and Zeus have already bought Hulkster a Christmas present. It's a body cast. You figure it out.
Boy, oh boy, what I have to contend with here in the WWF. Let's go now to Mean Gene Oakland. He'll bring us up to date on everything that's important.
Right from the Hulk's shoulders. Oh, he tried to tear his head.
Oh, wait a minute.
Right
on. Just one second.
What's he doing?
You're the survivor. And you beefcake. What are you going to do when there's no holes barred?
What was that? Look out, it's pandemonium in the locker room.
I love it.
I don't believe this. Let's get some guys in there. Let's get some control. Let's get some security.
It's no hold barred on Thanksgiving, Gorilla.
It's just beginning. Right now, we're going to take a short break here while we try to maintain some order.
Have to be a little strange to begin with to be willing to climb into a 15-foot-high steel cage where there are no rules, and you have to depend your livelihood and maybe your life, for that matter, depends on you and your partner. That's kind of a little bit outrageous, I think.
Sherry could wind up having no one to manage.
She's outside. Don't start
but
with
Sherry. She could wind up having no one to manage, I was going to say.
Like
don't
you.
Yell at me.
Like you. You're rapidly becoming a person who has no one to manage, aren't you? Hot Rod, I can remember when the Heenan family had 8 to 10 members. Now it's down to what, 2.5?
A lot of empty dinner plates now.
True or false? No comment. Oh, good.
You can hum while he plays the guitar.
Now that's the Christmas spirit. You're not speaking.
Later on, Hot Rod.
Pardon
right
me?
Now we're going to go to ringside in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens and take a look at one of the biggest men in the World Wrestling Federation, Nikolai Volkov, former co-holder of the World Wrestling Federation tag team title.
Just back from Russia. Happy as ever.
He was in Moscow, Leningrad, Kiev, and way down in the southern Georgian country in Tbilisi.
Atlanta?
So let's take you to Nikolai, save your life.
No, I said that.
You got it. You know what I'm talking
that
about.
That I can't play the
You guitar- can play a guitar, Piper?
Yeah.
Who are you kidding? You can't even hold it. He holds like one of those hayseed hicks.
He's sitting down right now.
Well, you have to be sitting on his knees. Couldn't be bent like that if you're standing up.
What makes you think that I'm not talented enough to play the guitar, Boobs?
Because you have to have some mind, some mentality to know how to play an instrument.
You obviously don't play anything.
Just play an instrument.
Maybe on the linoleum.
How about a little wager on this, then? How about
no money.
I don't want his money.
Okay, no money, but I'll tell you what. If I can play the guitar, and I mean well, if I can play the guitar, the next week on this show, you must come with an attitude of frankincense and mirth and glory and Christmas spirit.
Who's
and
Murph
all the little kinds of elves that come with it and the
Murph,
and the wonderfulness that comes with Christmas. And you may have frankincense. You can bring frankincense. You can and have the spirit of Christmas throughout the entire show and never say a negative word about anybody at any time.
Conrad, that's almost impossible for this.
What a nice bet, though.
What if I win?
What if you win?
Yeah.
Well, let's just think about that for a little bit, because we've got interesting matches lined up, and we're going to go to one of them when we come back.
I'm not saying I'm going to bet
them,
though.
It's, in fact, going to be anything you've ever won in your life, you lost in the very near future anyway. True or false?
False.
Intercontinental title, you won that. Goodbye, down the tubes. World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship, you won it. Boom, down the tubes.
It's only a matter of time till I get all that back.
You get it all
just
back.
Just a minor setback.
You think
if you can't take a minor setback, you don't belong being in the position
I'm
in.
You've had some major setbacks.
Roll
I got
it.
News for you. Let's take a look right now at Hillbilly taking out. Following that match, it was all self-explanatory. I think the genius is out of his gourd myself. I think that, you know, he's got Mr. Perfect. Why doesn't he be satisfied and happy with that? A contender for the title? No, he has to climb into the ring and display that horrible talent of his.
It shows that he's competitive.
He's competitive.
Sure. He has the genius. Mr. Perfect. He's just an advisor. He doesn't manage the man. But he's also a great wrestling talent. He's a great athlete.
Look,
we do the Hillbilly Gym.
Assets, too, I understand.
Well, it's you being a manager and an expert on wrestling, what is this here where he pirouettes and then this? And especially I love this effective wrestling move.
That's nice.
See?
Not many counters for that move.
Not a whole lot of counters
Okay, I'll tell
one.
You exactly what it is, and I probably shouldn't do this because it's none of my business, but...
But you're
the reason
anyway.
He does
never
all
stopped
this,
you before.
And the reason it works is because you're all concerned about it and asking about it. You see, what the genius is doing is right. He's playing with your minds. He's a genius.
Understand he also just got his own pilot's license. The only thing he's allowed to fly is biplanes. We'll be back in just a moment with more action and excitement here on Primetime Wrestling. The Survivor Series, what an event it was on Thanksgiving night in the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago. Right now, here's some special highlights for you from a big matchup that took place between the Big Boss Man and Dusty.
Hey. Oh, look out, the nightstick! Thrown in by Slick! The Boss Man's gonna have the last laugh here, Gorilla! Now watch a Slickster, he never does anything, Jess. Hey, he's a little over-enthusiastic. What did I say, Gorilla? Ha-ha! Just like that, the Slickster threw the big nightstick in, and Big Boss Man has clobbered everyone. Now he's going to read the dream, his rights, and do it for interrogation. He goes down. That'll cost you some heavy dollars, my friend. This one is over, but Dusty Rhodes paying a price here. Big Boss Man might have lost it, but Big Boss Man. Oh, look at Brutus. He's got the hedge clippers. And a Boss Man and a Slickster cleared out of there in a hurry.
That's what happens, folks, when you open the door and you let the Big Boss Man get his foot in there. This guy is vindictive.
Well, he's not only big and tough, he's a very cruel man.
Dangerous.
Oh, when you're cruel, you know, it's a little
disgusting. Disgusting.
Well, yeah, he's kind of that. Hmm. Not to me, but
sure, because you don't
the American fool's going to find out about it.
That takes a lot of gut. You know, it's one thing to be cruel in the ring when you're one-on-one and you just have that tenacity and you want to go for it. And it's another thing to spit on the dog, to kick the cat, to, you know, to that type of cruelty where you're doing nothing. You're trying to be a big man and feed your ego. Or cuff somebody to a rope. There's another one. What I think the common man has to do is forget this common. Go out and get some shackles and a Babe Ruth baseball bat and go to work on the man.
That's totally wrong.
Well, I agree.
You do not kick a cat.
What do?
You rub them with kibbles and bits and give them to the dog.
Will you stop? That's ridiculous. Your boss get man is indeed dangerous. And we're going to find out just how so right now as we take a look
then
at the big
you
boss
kick
man.
The dog.
The ball and chain.
Oh, come on.
You should know what he's doing, McMahon. You've been on a few chain gangs in your day, haven't you? Stop it. Lawson has him all hooked up now for no reason at all. Lawson hasn't done one thing except sign on for a match with a big boss man. Hey, it ain't no worse than Jake putting a snake on somebody. Oh, no. Oh, no. I hope he did his ab work. Oh, my goodness. Come on, ref. Get in there. Looking forward at all to a future encounter with a big boss man, and who would? Slick is giving this one. Oh, she slapped it! She slapped! She slapped Slick! And the big boss man, look at him! Look at him intimidate this little lady! Boss man is intimidating this little lady! Hey, I don't blame him! Wait a minute! There's a dream! Dusty Rhodes with that stick in hand, and the big boss man and Slick head for cover! You know, I think it's despicable what she did right there. She had no right to put her hands on Slick. A hug from the dream. Oh, isn't that touching? He's going to take her out of harm's way.
America.
All right, Dusty Rhodes. Protecting his own, taking care of business.
Hey, you want something to don't you be putting your hands on
Slick?
Across the lips, didn't she?
I can't believe it.
You can't believe it.
Mom's Mabley lives.
Will you stop? That was not Mom's Mabley.
Sure looked like it to me.
Was a dream fan. A
she's
kind of
chunky,
fan.
Isn't she?
I said she was.
I bet
a
she
big...
couldn't walk up to a discount store without the store dick stopping her.
Will you? She can't you point out some of her good points? I mean, jeepers. She got in there. She danced. She had rhythm. They were dancing. It was like Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. They were in there and they're having a great time. Can't you just pick out the good part? And then she whoop, boom, put them big liver lips of Slick's two times around them head of his.
You're right. There is something decent to say.
What?
I saw her dance.
Yes.
Do you ever see one of those big semis when they get hooked on ice on the highway and they can't keep it on the road? How they're knocking into the guardrails? That's just what I got out of it.
Yeah, but she had rhythm.
Yeah, nice rhythm.
I thought you were going to be nice this week.
No, I lied.
How about that bet?
I'll bet whatever you want. Nice just get off my week. Case. Whatever he wants, I'll bet.
Here's a guy that's nice all the time.
Foundation is built on the slamming power of the anvil and the disarming skill of the hitman. The Hart Foundation. Now this duo has Hart.
Wednesday, December 27th, it'll all happen, and it's all available on pay-per-view. Here's a match that's not available on pay-per-view. It's Hacksaw Jim Duggan and a friend of yours, the big African dream.
Akeem. But, you know, I'll tell you another thing. They not only can see the movie The Match or the match
the match and the movie
that's
is what
I was going
to
say and Akeem isn't. What are you confusing me about?
It's not hard to confuse you, believe me.
Right there.
It's well calculated move. Look at this, slips right down in behind him and hooks him with an underhook and gets a very impressive win over Akeem. We'll be back. Not very often that you're going to see the big African dream Akeem get defeated, but with the likes of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, this guy could take anybody out of the picture. True or false? Don't play anymore, Hot Rod.
Here comes.
This guy's willing to make a bet over here, a wager of some kind.
Oh, I thought maybe you were commenting on how lousy he sounds.
No, I don't want him to play now and show everybody that he can play.
You said you'd bet. Boobs.
Yeah, but he hasn't said what.
Okay, what was it again? I have to be very nice next week, and
I'll put it real, real simple for you too, Boobs. What you gotta do is next week You gotta have the Christmas spirit with frankincense and mirth, and maybe even bring a little present for us. And with the attitude that Christmas is a wonderful time of year, the best time of year, and without one negative comment to anybody at any time.
Okay, and if I win that bet, which I will,
yeah,
then you have to be like Scrooge next week. You have to feel just about Christmas like I do. That is a waste of time.
But I like Christmas.
Well, you want to bet or not? Come on, put up your guitar or shut up.
Put up my guitar. Make you a bet.
Fell into my trap again.
Gonna play you a tune.
You fell
into your socks off.
You fell into my trap again, dummy. Get ready to hate the holidays.
Here comes Santa Claus.
See what I have to put up with here, folks. Even in the holiday season.
Now play something now. Let's hear him play.
He's not going to play now. Why should he?
Wait a minute. You made me bet now he's not going to play? We'll be right back with the Bushwhackers.
I got to warm up.
We spoke to the model earlier. Here's what he had to say.
Beefcake, this Wednesday, you and Hulk Hogan are going to watch the movie No Holds Barred and then get into a cage against Macho King and Zeus. Well, if there's anything left of you, I want it because I want to personally destroy you.
Yes, huh? Whether good or what, huh? Look at the shape. Look at the shape.
He does look good. But looking good is only part of the story, Jesse.
What did he buy? He got him a tie, man.
Well, I'll be.
A gorgeous-looking tie.
Is that the same tie that he bought you?
No. Problem is, he couldn't buy that for you either.
Couldn't buy what?
That's a good-looking tie. Would never catch up to any of your suits.
Look at this. Oh, come on! Now you know why I gave him the tie.
He's just trying to put it on him. Teach him how to tie that double knot.
Slick in the background, still talking with the referee. And the tie has taken its toll on Warren Bianchi. Bianchi on his feet, maybe not for long. Nice drop kick.
Beautiful drop kick.
And the model drops an elbow. The model in control. What's he doing here?
Ooh, wow. Big power backbreaker right there.
Right up into the rib area. And the model trying to get his opponent over for the Boston Crab. And that's all she wrote. Come on, let him go. Let him go, Martel.
Here is your winner, the model.
This guy is really stuck on himself.
You know, wait a minute. How can you say that? When he gave Bianchi a present, now he's going to give him another little present.
Yeah.
Wham, pile driver. Ha.
Oh, come on.
And now he's going to tie the tie on him.
What is this?
Look, he's not choking him with it. Just tying it on real nice, making him look good.
That's what you call a fashion makeover.
A fashion makeover. You definitely could use a fashion makeover, McMahon.
Beefcake is going to...
Here you see Martel. Beautiful drop kick right there. Tremendous altitude on that. Flips Bianchi over into the Boston Crab and gets a submission.
Those pearly white teeth may be no longer after Beefcake gets a hold of it. Much less lack of hair. Wait a minute here. It looks like the Superfly is playing the Nintendo game WrestleMania. Ooh, look out. Jesse, how's he doing?
Well, you know one thing, McMahon.
What?
If the Superfly can play it, you can get it for your pet monkey for Christmas.
Stop it. This is big, very big in the Fiji Islands as well as all over everywhere.